money. Bars. C5. Just incredible. Hunger flow too. It's easy.
Incredible.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we are in Silicon Valley at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara.
Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the San Francisco 49ers. Here's the Australian-born punter, Mitch Wishnowsky, to get things going.
And we are underway from Santa Clara.
That's going to be taken in inside the five, but the fair catch will move it out to the 25-yard line. Allen going to look to throw on the first play.
And his first look is incomplete.
That's a tough spot for a running back coming out of the backfield because you know he's got to look for the football. Knowing full well, he's got a man coming his way, full steam, and he broke that one up.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line.
On play action, Allen.
He finds Latavius Murray. He finds some open field here.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
They run for the first time with James Cook.
He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about four, second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Second and six.
To throw, it's Allen.
And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over at that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
Well, that was his first target of the game, and it's going to take at least one more target to get him on the board. Took a nice substantial hit to draw that catch loose from it. Incomplete pass.
He's got his target. That's complete.
And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs. 45 yards.
And the Bills get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon.
The extra point by Bass. Up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Tyler Bass to kick off for Buffalo.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10.
At their own 17-yard line. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he is his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw it for a loss.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable third and three.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play. It's fourth down.
Oh, they're changing this at the line. Going quickly out to the right side. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off for the first down. Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time, we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be really physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
Tackle on the play by Christian Benford. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
A second down throw for Purdy. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I will see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
Purdy with it on third and long. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 11 yards for number 11.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Purdy completes this one here to McCaffrey. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Back to throw, Purdy. Buying time to his left. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. After one, 7-0. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a second and 14 upcoming.
Let's go now. 18 Cardinals. 70 Lions.
Ayuk going to go in motion right. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. I was pretty surprised there when they lined up to run it on second and long, but it worked out for them.
It certainly did, and that requires some confidence, some fortitude, and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out on the next down.
Kyle Shanahan's made the decision. They're going on fourth down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. They're going to go on fourth down here. Purdy now to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10. Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. In motion left goes Jennings. McCaffrey is not going to get in here as they push him back to the 2-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defensive front there. They held their ground, pretty much stoned them on that play, and ended up creating a lost yardage play.
Yeah, drop them from the one back to the two. Back at the two now, here's second and goal. Again, McCaffrey. Christian McCaffrey taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Niners are an extra point away from evening this one up. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Jake Moody now for the point after. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Allen looks to throw on second down. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Multiple defenders getting home there for a loss of 11. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. So after the sack, Allen and the Bills with work to do on third and long. Operating from the gun, Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. A crazy sequence here. A huge game that time, but it still leaves him well short for fourth down. They do go for it. Here's Allen. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. First down, it's Purdy. And this one's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, 49ers. Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the 49ers have now taken the lead.
Now Moody for the PAT.
and he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
Allen gonna throw. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Allen now on first down.
Shakir hauls it in. And they will have a first down as they are definitely in field goal range now, down at the 20-yard line.
Operating from the red zone now, Allen. And he's going to go down back at the 27-yard line. He's sacked. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Throwing on second and long. Allen. And Davis has it over the middle. And the Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here for 3rd and 12. So the shotgun snap to Allen. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. A final shot before half for Allen. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Fred Warner. It's a foot race. And into the end zone. A pick six for the 49ers as they score the touchdown. So from 1 end zone all the way to the other. Talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tent.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the 3rd quarter. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the 2nd half. I know they're down, but starting the 3rd quarter there with the onside kick, what'd you think?
Well, I think that they're looking at it as we may not have as many possessions in this game as we want. There may be that sense and that feel that they've got to go ahead and make something happen, steal possession, try and steal some points, and get themselves right back in a position to try and win the game.
And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc, because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
From the 48-yard line, here's the 2nd and 9.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And now off to the races, down the right side. And did he get in? No! They'll mark him out at the 1-yard line.
106 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
So you got the lead here in the second half. Obviously, you love big runs like that at any time. Here, you really like them.
And how about the confidence that's being exhibited by that offense now? They don't care what you're lining up doing on the defensive side. They want the big fella to carry the football and carry it often.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco.
Have moved out in front by three touchdowns. Moody good with the extra point.
And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Allen off the play fake. Throw left side complete. That's Cook. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six. After 45.
Now Allen throwing on second down.
Into the hands of the tight end, Dalton Kincaid.
And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 27-yard line. 27 yards there, a first down. And again, it's Allen. That's going to be caught. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Allen now looks to throw. And he'll throw this one away. But I don't think he was out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag.
Well, we saw it too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
So after the loss of down, they'll come up here with a second and goal. To the air, Allen. Sheds off the tackle. Touchdown, Bills.
Gabriel Davis.
An 18-yard touchdown grab.
And the Bills are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. So now Allen and the Bills going to stay out and go for two.
They'll try and throw for it. Rolling to his right. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. And they decide fairly early here they need the ball back, so here's an onside kick. And the 49er hands team does its job. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an outside kick situation.
All about the numbers.
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
15 for the Niners there and a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
That's the linebacker Matt Milano getting up and stopping him for a loss.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. And the tight end goes in motion left.
Play action, now Purdy.
And this is caught, Jennings. And out of bounds. defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter.
And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Christian McCaffrey, a 3-yard touchdown run.
And the 49ers will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. Moody good with the extra point.
And the lead opens up now to 22 points.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Fair catch called for and taken down near the 5-yard line, and this will come out to the 25.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive.
Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've got to be pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, put the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Throwing on first down is Allen. Flush to his right. That's complete to Davis. All that for a 2-yard gain, second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On second down, here's Allen. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
Throwing is Allen on third. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Throwing now is Allen. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Under four to go now as they come up on second down. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga. And the Niners are going to take possession here at their own six.
Dealing, I got off the block. Took the hate and put that in the watch. Had to ice on my neck, cause little shorty on hot.